So basically, collection means just like we have array. So let's revise array first. So array is something like collection only. So properties of array is array can hold similar type of elements, right? So we know this. So array can hold similar types of element. Okay. Now, you know, there are few problems with array, right? So first thing is that its property itself, that array can hold only similar types of element. Only similar types of element, that is homogeneous elements. Okay, arrays can hold only homogeneous element. Second thing is that arrays are fixed in size. Okay, so when I declare here array like this, int, let's say int a is equal to new int 10, then array holds just 10. So 10 size is fixed, right? You cannot change the size of the array further, right? So array, you cannot increase or decrease the size of the array. Okay, you cannot increase or decrease the size of the array, right? So these disadvantages we are going to overcome in collections, right? So collection. So let's go with the presentation. Collections. Okay, so why collections? So collections are actually growable in nature. Collection can hold both homogeneous as well as heterogeneous elements, right? So every collection class is implemented based on some data structure. So ready-made data support is available. Means actually collections can not only just hold the values, but they have so many internal inbuilt functions they have. So with the help of those, we can do several operations using collections. Now arrays versus collection. Let's compare arrays with collections. So arrays are good if we know size in advance, right? So like this, if we know size in advance, then arrays will be good in size, good choice, right? But it's not like that. If I use ArrayList is actually a kind of collection. We are going to see this, but it's not like that when I say ArrayList is growable in nature. So it's not simply that if I want to add one more element here greater than its own size, so simply I'll put or create one more place and put the value there. No, it's not going to happen in this way, right? So what is going to happen actually in ArrayList? So one more ArrayList will be going to create, right, with one place extra. Then that new element will be added to that and the pointer will be updated. Okay, so ArrayList, its pointer will be updated and the old list will be deleted, right? So this is the whole process that going to happen in case of collection, that is ArrayList. ArrayList is one of the type of collection, right? So performance is actually, performance wise, ArrayList is not that good. Okay, so let's compare it with the help of table, right? So arrays are fixed in size and collections are growable in nature, right? With respect to memories, arrays are not recommended to use because they are in fixed size. So with respect to memory, collections are recommended to use. Then with respect to performance, arrays are recommended to use because those are lightweight, and with respect to performance, collections are not recommended to use. Arrays can hold only homogeneous data types, and collection can hold both homogeneous as well as heterogeneous element. There is no underlying data structure for array, so ready-made method support is not available. Means there are no inbuilt functions, so those can do some several operations on array. But every collection is implemented based on some data structure, so the ready-made method support is available for every requirement. Okay. And arrays can hold both primitive object. We have seen in wrapper class what is primitive and non-primitive, right? So arrays can hold both primitive and non-primitive. Object types are non-primitive. So arrays can hold both primitive and non-primitive objects, but collection can hold only non-primitive, right? Collection cannot hold the normal primitive objects, right? Like integer, character, but it can hold its wrapper class. Right, so this is the difference between arrays and collection. Yes, have you understood this basic things? Soon we are going to implement each and everything, but are you understanding the basic things? Arrays versus collection, please confirm. Say yes if you understood, or if there is any doubt that you have to understand. Yes, 6 points. Collections are growable in nature. With respect to memory, collections are recommended to use. Performance wise, collections are not recommended to use. Collection holds both homogeneous and heterogeneous elements. Collection has many inbuilt methods, and collection can hold only object, that is non-primitive. Okay. Non-primitive. Actually this point we will come to know, right? So don't worry, we'll come to know this point, because we are going to implement soon. I am going to implement, don't worry, I'll be explaining you while taking example. Okay, so because collection actually holds non-primitive only, I'll show you how it is, don't worry. So this is the hierarchy of the collection framework. Just observe. So basically, collection is an interface, and it is a child interface of iterable interface, right? Just understand the hierarchy. So collection is the child interface of iterable interface, and collection mainly have three child interfaces, that is list, queue, and set. Only three: list, queue, and set. Okay, and one by one we are going to see. So actually this purple color boxes are interfaces, and these yellowish colors are actually the classes, and we know that only classes can be instantiated, so that we can have the object of these classes only. So just understand that collection is the interface, and we have child interfaces list, queue, and set, right? So out of which, one by one we are going to see. Don't worry if you are seeing this, there are so many interfaces, so many classes are there, so just don't worry. Collection is the only parent, and whatever methods we have in collection, all the same methods are applicable here. Only there will be a small difference in between each of these classes or the interfaces. Some properties will be different, some background things will be different, and for some of the properties you even don't need to care about it, because that will happen in the background only. Okay, so one by one we are going to deal with each and every. And remember, if you just understand one collection, so understanding rest of the collection part is not that difficult, right? So again, there are so many methods here, but we are going to see only the essential methods, that will be using in the implementation of the automation, right? And remember, this is the last part from the Java. So soon after completion of this, most probably in the next week, we are going to start with the Selenium. Okay, so we are going to start learning with the first interface of collection, that is the list. Okay, so list. So let's just see what is list. Actually, map is also there, but we will deal with this. Just don't worry about this. So first interface, that is list. Okay, so there are so many unwanted things also there. Okay, so list interface. So list interface is the child interface of collection interface. It inherits a list type of data structure which can be stored in ordered collection. Remember, so this is the ordered collection, right? Ordered means the order in which you will add the element, it will be stored in the same order, right? So list is ordered collection. It can have duplicate values, right? So based on these checkpoints, you have to differentiate between the different collection types, right? So list is an interface which can have ordered values. It can have duplicate values, and list implements list is implemented by ArrayList, linked list, vector, and stack. These are the four child classes of list interface. Okay, so look at this. Then there are various methods in the list that can use to insert, delete, and access the elements from the list that we will soon see. So let's just see what are the child classes of the list interface. To instantiate list interface, we must include ArrayList, linked list, vector, or stack, right? So you can implement the list interface using ArrayList, linked list, vector, and stacks. So don't worry, we will implement it one by one. So first we will pick up with the ArrayList. Okay, so ArrayList. So Java ArrayList class can contains duplicate element. Okay, so just the properties, we will read it first, and we will implement ArrayList, and so many methods are there, we will learn that as well. So ArrayList can contain duplicate element. ArrayList class maintains insertion order. The order in which the elements are added, it will be stored in the same order. Java ArrayList class is non-synchronized. It is just a property. We don't have to implement this. Just understand it is non-synchronized. Java ArrayList allows random access because array works on index spaces. In Java ArrayList class, manipulation is slow because of a lot of shifting occurs if any element is removed from the ArrayList. Just like previously we have seen in that diagram, right? How the element is added. So manipulation part is slow, but if you your frequent operation is search, so search can be done quite faster way, because ArrayList is quite like a array, and it sequentially the elements are stored. Okay, so let's see one of the example of ArrayList. So I'll show you here, and let's just verify the properties of the ArrayList. So properties of the ArrayList we have seen here. So ArrayList properties. So first is it maintains order. Second is it allows heterogeneous elements. Okay, it allows heterogeneous element. Then it allows null. It allows null. So these are few checkpoints that you have to check for each individual collection, right? So it allows null. What else? It maintains order, it allows null, it allows heterogeneous elements. What else we have? Non-synchronized insertion, allows duplicates also. It allows duplicate. Okay, so we are going to verify these points. It allows duplicate elements. Okay, so it allows duplicate elements or duplicate values. Fine. So let's create a class here. Let's open our project. Okay, so here we will create a package here. Right click and say new package. Let's say collections demo. And here again I'll create one more package, or let me create directly a class here. So ArrayListDemo. Okay, ArrayListDemo. Fine. So public static void main. Here let's create an ArrayList. So ArrayList is a class, ArrayList, right? So you can create ArrayList, let's say AL is equal to new ArrayList. Okay, so ArrayList is an inbuilt class in a collection framework which is there in the Java. So I have created an object of the ArrayList. So let's add some elements here. So I'll add several elements here. So let's say AL.add. I'll add some strings here. So let's say ABC1, or let me just add some random name. Let's say Amol. We'll add all of the names here, or different names. Let's say Amol, Anil. Let's say all names starts with A, Abhishek. Okay, so remember, this is the order: Amol, Anil, Aparna, Abhishek, Priyanka. So to print, you can directly print it like this: system.out.println al, right? So this is one way to print the list. So say right click and run. Okay, so Amol, Anil, Aparna, Abhishek, Priyanka. So the order in which it is added, so in the same order we can see it is displayed, right? So order is maintained, right? So this point is verified. It maintains the order. Let's say verified. Okay, so whether it allows null, let's just try this. So if I say al.add null, there is no issue here. And also while printing, I can see null is allowed, there is no issue. Whether it allows duplicate, so duplicates, let's try the duplicate element. So I'll duplicate the last element here, Priyanka. Right click and run. There is no issue, I think. Yes, there is no issue. So it allows duplicate, and this important thing, whether it allows the heterogeneous element or not, right? So our array actually don't allow the heterogeneous element, but here let's just see. So all the elements are string. So let me add one integer here, al.add integer, al.add. I'll add one double type of element, al.add. I'll add one character here, al.add. What else I can add? Boolean. Okay, so you see, so ArrayList allows the heterogeneous element. But actually this property is of no use for us, but still we'll verify this. So let's run this. Yeah, data also can be added, right? So it allows all the heterogeneous kind of elements. So let me just try date as well. So let's say date date is equal to new date. After all, this is an object only, so al dot add date. Okay, so right click and run. You see the date is displayed here, today's date. Okay, so ArrayList allows the heterogeneous element, right? It proves that. So since hence verified. Okay, verified. Fine. So now what happened here? Yes. So now this is one way to display the list. So there are several other ways to display the list, right? So first thing is using for loop. Okay, so the number of elements in the list, right? So number of elements in the list can be determined with the method size. Okay, so size is the method using which you can get the number of elements, right? So for example, in this list 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 elements are there. So if you print system.out.println, let's say al.size, okay, so it should be 11. Right click and run. Okay, so elements are displayed here and the size is 12. Oh, I think 12 it is. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12th is the date. Okay, so 12th is the date. Just a second. Hey, Vaishali? Vaishali? Darlaun jayanke laad gyanza varak. Kupav jate. Yes, so 12 is the size, right? So I haven't counted this date. Okay, so there is one way to display the list in this format, right? So directly if you print or use the AL, so it will be printed like this. Okay, so now I'll show you another way to print the list using loop. Okay, so for loop. So for loop, as I know the size is al.size, so I'll traverse the for loop like this. So integer I is equal to 0, I is less than al.size I plus plus. Okay, so here inside this I'll print system.out.println. Now each individual element can be retrieved using get method. Get index I is the index. And here also indexing starts from 0. Okay, so if I print here, let's say just before printing this for loop, I'll show you how it prints. So if I say system.out.println and al.get, indexing starts from 0. If I say 1, so first index is at first index there is Anil, so Anil should be printed separately. So after the size, the last sentence will be the Anil. Okay, you see, so first at index 1 there is Anil. So similarly, if I want to print all elements, so I'll print it using for loop like this. So using get method, so al dot get, put I over here. So one by one, one after the other, from 0 till the size, it will print all the elements one after the another. Retrieve means get the values. Retrieve means get the values. Okay, so yes, all the values are retrieved, means all the values are here. So starting from Amol, right? So actually this is printed one after the another because we have ln over here. Okay, so this is one way, or this is another way, because one way we have seen directly printing al and then using for loop. Another way is using for each. So this for each is used for each loop. So this can be applied in array as well, right? So for each loop, so I'll write here comment system dot, this is a normal for loop, this is a normal for loop. What is mean by heterogeneous? Heterogeneous means not homogeneous. Homogeneous means similar types of element. Heterogeneous means different types of element. Okay, heterogeneous means different types of elements. Here you see string, then null, then integer, float, then character, boolean, right? So different data types. So yes, normal for loop. So I have printed using normal for loop. Now I am going to teach you the different way of representing the for loop. This is actually only applicable for the sequential data like collection or the arrays. So this for loop will not be applicable everywhere. So let's see how it is. So right here for, then identify what type of list it is, right? So sorry, actually I cannot use this in the heterogeneous, right? So for each loop cannot be used in heterogeneous list. Okay, why, you will come to know this when I'll show you this. So let's keep it aside. So let's see some other way to print this. So using iterator interface. Okay, so using iterator interface. Okay, so just understand the way how it is printed. So actually normally we are going to use for loop only, but just let's say how it is printed using iterator interface, right? So in the iterator interface there are few methods already implemented, we will just use those. So iterator name it something. So itr is equal to, now use the al, right? So al is actually the name of the collection, that is array list. So al dot iterator. Okay, so al dot iterator, and we can traverse this itr using the while loop. So say like this, while itr dot has next. Okay, so whether the elements has the next element, and also it will iterate to the next element. And system dot out dot println iterator or itr dot next, that's it. So this is another way to print the elements, right? So using iterator and while loop, itr dot has next and itr dot next. Itr dot next prints the element as well as it moves to the next, right? So its implementation is already done in the iterator interface, right? So run this. So using iterator interface, again you will see the same elements printed over here using iterator interface, right? So now let's make the list generic. Next topic, let's make the list generic means not homogeneous. Means not heterogeneous. heterogeneous, right? Generic means not heterogeneous, means homogeneous, means all element same. Now I am going to restrict the list to allow only similar type of elements, right? So we are now going to restrict the list to allow only specific types of elements, right? So we are going to need the generic list only, right? Not the heterogeneous, but this is just a property, so we verified. So how to make a list generic? Look at this. So let's create another example, collection demo. So array list, array list, just a second, actually I have Abhishek's question, right? Hasnext actually, hasnext is a method that returns true or false, right? So if the element is there in the next index, then it returns true, or if the element is not there in the next index, then it returns false, right? So this is about the hasnext. Okay, so right click and say new Java class, and array list demo, array list demo 2. Okay, and I'll copy few things from here, okay, at least up to this. Okay, now I'm just going to allow only the strings here. So to allow only the strings, make this put this two angled bracket and write here string. Okay, and optionally you can also write here string, but it's okay if you don't give, right? So once you make it a string, right, so the other elements won't be allowed now using add method. So right here, so if I try to insert here other element other than string, so it is not allowed, right? So there is error here, it is not allowed, right? And here I can show you using the for each, right? So printing, the rest of the printing will be same here. So printing using for each. Okay, so right here for, identify what type of elements are here. So I can see here elements are of type string, so put here string. Create one variable of string, let's say str, then put a colon there, then name the variable of the collection al, right? And simply print the variable str. Okay, I'll tell you once again. Write for here, identify what type of list is. I can see it is string. So write here string, create one variable here, put a colon, write the name of the collection al, and simply print this variable. Now it will be printed, your list will be printed one by one. So this is how the for each works. You see, all the elements are printed. Let me tell you once again, identify the type of the list, it is string. Create a variable, put a colon, choose the name of the list, and print using the variable. So this is actually the format of for each. The same is applied for array also. You can try with array also. Okay, so yes, so this is the array list of string. So let's create another array list of integer. Okay, so yes, Abhishek, your question was there earlier, you didn't cleared about the sixth point. The sixth point was from the list. So collection framework collection framework allows only non primitive data types. Okay, so we have seen in wrapper class what is primitive and non primitive. So primitive data types are what? Primitive data types are normal data types like your integer, then float, character, right? So these are actually primitive data types, right? Your boolean. So these are not allowed. So now I want to create a generic list of integer, right? So if I want to create a generic list of integer, I cannot write like this array list and put a angle bracket and write here int. This is not allowed. This is a primitive data type. This is not allowed. But it's not like that. I cannot create a generic list of integer. I can create a generic list of integer, but here instead of primitive data type, I have to put non-primitive data type, that is integer, the wrapper class of int, right? So I have to put a non-primitive data type of integer, that is integer. Okay, so let's create some another variable. AL2 is equal to new array list like this. Again, this is optional. It automatically get created. You can write here, and also you can optionally write here integer as well, right? So there is nothing wrong in it, right? Generally people keep the things like this, right? Even if you write it in this way, that is also fine. Fine. So now this is the array list which is created, and it allows only integer. Okay, it will allow only integer. So try this. So AL2, let's say 12. Okay, you can put any, sorry, AL2.add. Add is the method to add the elements here. AL2.add integer. Okay, so let's add some more elements here. Okay. Like this. And if you try to add anything other than integer, it won't be allowed. You see, there is error here. It is not allowed, right? Because we have made the list generic to integer. Similarly, I'll just show you the other ways as well. So let's say array list of character is written like this. You cannot use char here. You have to use the wrapper class of the character. So character, right? Let's say AL3 is equal to new character like this. Okay. Sorry, here I have to write here array list. Okay, what else? Boolean. You can create the boolean. So again boolean, right? You cannot use the small b as for boolean, right? Or if you want to create a double, sometimes you will create doubles as well, right? So AL5, you can create double. Okay, so you can get the array list of double. Okay, so in this way you can add the elements like this, right? So if it is double, so let's add at least two elements in every collection. So AL5.add 23.56, right? So let's say 21 point. This is a boolean type, so I can add al4.add boolean value can be only true or false. Okay, true or false. You are not allowed to use any other than any other values. So character here we can add AL3.add only the characters. Okay, so like this. okay, some other character. Fine. So this is the character. Okay, so this is the list. Yes, are you getting up to this? How to use the list, array list? There are several methods as well. We are going to see one by one. Okay, so yes, are you clear up to this? Please confirm. Or if you have any query, please raise it. Okay, good. So let's just see what we have next in array list. So this is the example we have seen. Other methods, let's see what methods we have array list. Add, we have seen add all, remove, remove all, remove if, clear, is empty. Okay, let's just see some simple methods here. So what I'll do is I'll copy this in notepad and let's see all the methods one by one. Array list methods. So let's just see how much we can cover. Collection.sort. Array list. Is empty is there, get and set. Okay, so only this method, is empty is there, get and set is there. Get we have seen already, set we have to see. Okay, so out of which add we are done with. Then we have also seen this get method. Size method is not mentioned here, I think. Okay, so we will see some methods here. So clear method we will see. Okay, so clear method actually clears the array, right? So clear method, what it does, it clears the list. Okay, so let's just see how it works. Simple methods we will see first, then we will see the rest of them. Okay, is empty is already mentioned here. Yeah, so clears the list. Let's try this list. Okay. Okay, I'll comment this printing so that we will only get the output. Okay, we will try with this integer. So system.out.println. I'll say here before clear AL2. Okay, and we will call the clear method here. So AL2.clear, and we will say after clear. Okay, so look at this, right click and run. See, this is before clear, this is after clear, so all elements are vanished from the list. Okay, and look at this. So the next method we'll see is empty. So is empty returns true if the list is empty. Okay, so is empty returns true if the list is empty. So here you see, in this case, if I try to print here al2.isEmpty, so now actually the list is not empty. So let's just see what it prints here, and let's just see what it prints here after the clear. So isEmpty here it should be true, and here it should be false, because here it is not empty, right? So right click and run. Okay, so here it is false because the list is not empty here. There are some elements here, and here the list is empty, so this is true. Fine, simple function is this. Okay, So collection dot sort. Okay, we will see this collection dot sort. Okay. So if suppose, so this is actually already sorted or what? No, it is not sorted. So it will be sorted in the default natural sorting order. Okay. So what we will do is I'll comment this clear. Okay. And I'll call this method collection dot sort, and the list name here is al2. If it is alphabetical, if it is a string, then it will be sorted with default natural sorting order, that is alphabetical order. Here it will be the order will be, let's say, sorted. Order will be ascending, sorted. Okay, so when I apply this, then the sorted will be like this. So let's just see. Okay, so now the sorted is, you see, in the ascending order it is, right? So these elements are shuffled, right? So 66 is placed at the last, right? So it is sorted. Let's just see how it will happen if I used in this list. Okay, so Amol, Anil, Aparna, Abhishek. Let's just see. So collections dot sort al, and so this sort method applies only homogeneous list, right? Because element must be comparable if you want to sort the element, right? So sorted, and we'll print it before sort. So before sort. Okay, so just see this. Okay, so before sort, this is the order, and after sort, the order is changed. Actually, Abhishek is first, then Amol, then Anil, then Aparna, then Priyanka. So the default natural sorting order is us using the alphabetical order, right? So this is the collection dot sort. Getting it? So this is collection dot sort. Then we have set method. Okay, so set method is, you can set at particular index. For example, look at this. We'll consider this list. Okay, so here if you use al.set, right? So here you have to pass the index and the element, right? So at which index? So let's suppose at first index, that is at the place of Anil, I want to set, let's say, new element. Okay, and print the list after set, right? So after set, so at index 1, that is this, at this place there will be new element. Okay, so right click and run. Right, so after set, you see here in the output, so at the first place, this is 0th one and this is the first one. So here actually there is new element, right? So yes, Anil is already there because we have sorted here, so the list is sorted. So in the place of Amol, it is new element, right? So Anil is there because the array is the list is sorted here. Okay, so yes, so this is also done. Set is done. Okay, then we will see add all, remove we will see first. Okay, this is again a simple, for add all and removal we need to create one more list. Okay, so remove we will see, remove and let's see this here. Let's say al dot remove, right? You can remove by index or you can remove by object. Okay, so you can directly put here Priyanka, or let's say new element. We will remove the new element, right? So newly added element, I'll remove it, and now I'll print this, let's say after remove. Okay, so new element should be removed. Set only replaces, it does not adds new element, right? Set only replaces, it does not add new element. Okay, so yes, so after remove, you see new element is absent in the list. Okay, so after remove, new element is absent in the list. Fine. So this is the functionality of remove. You can remove either using the object, or you can also remove using index also. So let's say index 3. So after removal of new element, whatever the list will be there, so from that the third index element will be removed. So look at this. This is after removal of the new element, right? So here new element is absent, and third index 0, 1, 2 and 3. One Priyanka will be vanished, right? So in the new list, there is one Priyanka absent, right? So this is using index, this is using object. Okay, so yes, this is done. Now we have few methods, add all, remove all and remove if. So these methods we will see in the next session. So these are quite bigger one, right? So we need to understand it. But yes, remember one thing, whatever methods that we are learning in this class today, so all the methods are similarly applicable to all of the collections, right? It's just that they have few newer methods, just that they have some different properties. It's just this, that they have internal operation different, but similar things will be there. So time to time, I'll be telling you how those different collections are different, right? And we will understand it very easily. So don't worry, even if it looks this is very vast, but see, this is the structure of the hierarchy of the collection framework. So even it looks vast, but don't worry, we are going to complete it very properly. Fine. So have you got this? Have you understood today's session? Okay. Fine then. Today we will stop here and we will meet on Monday and we will continue the collections, and probably in 2 to 3 days we are going to jump into the Selenium and we'll start with the automation. Yes, I'll be sharing this on the GitHub as well. So thank you very much guys, and have a nice week.